How often, if at all, would you repeat a CAC? And can you tell us what a CAC is?
Yes. CAC is a coronary calcium score. And so coronary calcium scores are a really great way to help people make decisions, giving them another point, essentially. Remember, we don't want to miss the forest for the trees. And sometimes that can happen when it comes to cardiovascular risk reduction. We want to be able to have as many data points as we can. And somebody's coronary calcium score can be a very helpful point here. So in other words, if someone's had high cholesterol all their life, they go on a lifestyle intervention like the Virta treatment and their cholesterol stays elevated instead of going down like it does with many of our patients, or potentially even goes up, and they have a coronary calcium score of zero, that's a really different place than someone who has had a lifetime of high cholesterol and has a very, very high coronary calcium score. So a coronary calcium score is a CT scan. People go in, they can usually be had for very low prices. I know in our area, Indiana University Health offers them for $49. It's a very quick test, in, out, and what the CT is looking for is calcium. Calcium in the arteries that supply the heart with blood. And so what a coronary calcium score should be is zero. In other words, no evidence of heart disease that has developed into coronary plaque or calcium. Now, anyone who has a positive coronary calcium score, even if it's low positive, using and checking this over time, one of the big things that's going to be a factor there is statin medication use. Because anyone with high cholesterol who then has a positive coronary calcium score, if they get started on a statin, their coronary calcium score actually has the potential to increase. But that doesn't necessarily mean that that's a bad thing, because calcium in that plaque shows us that it's stable. And I'm gonna go here and digress just a little bit into coronary artery disease physiology. Many people think of a heart attack as a clogged tube, right? So you develop disease in your arteries and they get smaller and smaller in diameter until one day they close. That's actually not what happens with heart attacks and coronary artery disease progression to an actual event. What happens is there's a degree of disease in an artery, and for whatever reason, there becomes a piece of this plaque that's unstable. It gets kicked off, floats downstream, blocks the flow of blood, and that causes the heart disease, the heart attack. So what we want to do if someone has any degree of disease is we want to stabilize it. And when we stabilize it, that can actually be seen as an increase in the coronary artery calcium score, but that can mean in many people stabilization of disease, so that's really important. Mm-hmm. But I love the coronary artery calcium score in people as, again, an additional data point. And we can have a really good discussion together at what that person's individual risk factors are and what is our next logical step. And it's a decision that should always be a shared decision. I think this is so important. I will never say, here's a prescription, you need to take it. Because taking a new prescription, I mean, that's a really big decision to be made. And it should be made as a team. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be one person dictating what another person does. It should be to say, let's put all the ducks on the table, if you will. Let's talk about your risk factor and let's come up together with what our treatment path is going forward.